Welcome to the Toffee Blues Extra Show, your midweek extra source of all things Everton. We're back, Tom and Max, this week, your favourite little duo. But we're back. Welcome, Max, to the back to the show again. Obviously, we've done the intro, so we're back and we're going to talk about allowing Mason Holgate out on loan, because it's an issue that's come up. I think Sky Sports were the ones who raised the issue this week and said that Sky Sports sources understand that. Marcus Silva's made the decision, or maybe Marcel Brands made the decision, to let Holgate out on loan because the 22-year-old isn't getting opportunities anymore. He did at the start of the season. They've kind of waned because we've obviously got strength in depth at the moment at centre-back. We've obviously got a dilemma even without Holgate in the picture. We've obviously got me and Akeen on Zuma to choose from. And even I think Jagielka might even be ahead of the pecking order, I've seen, and come off the bench. I can't remember which game it was, but he came off the bench. It might have been against Chelsea to show things up. I think it was because he couldn't bring Zuma on. So, he's gone well down the pecking order, Holgate anyway. And I think he's a quality little centre back, but we might have to send him out on loan just for his own development, really. But I don't know, would you be sad to see him out on loan?
I've got to be honest, no. I don't want him to leave the club permanently because I think he's an absolute, you know, he's a rough diamond in that sense. I think, obviously, he come from Barnsley, didn't he? So he's literally, you know, you want to lash the next tags on him. It certainly seems like he's going to be the next John Stones. Kind of, you know, being through the same academy, being through the same clubs. But, yeah, as you say, with the dilemma that's posed at centre-half at the current moment, you know, Zuma, Mina and Keane, they are three senior players who are, you know, in healthy competition for starting places. I'm pretty sure Mason Holgate's last game was the 3-1 loss to West Ham at home. Obviously, that was our last, you know, I think it was our last home loss for a while, and he didn't cover himself in glory that game. I think he made a few mistakes and struggled to cope with Arnautovic and Yarmolenko. Kind of slipped, and I think as a product of that, he has slipped down the pecking order. Hopefully he doesn't take too much discouragement from that. As you know, whatever, and we need to be competitive. If players don't deliver, it's going to have to be a case that they slip down the pecking order. Fortunately for Holgate, he's only, what is it, 20, 21?
Yeah, 22, I think.
A bit older than that. But he's still a really young player that plays like an old head on young shoulders. And unlike John Stones, he doesn't pull off Cruyff's hands in his own 6-yard box. It's literally, I think, the fundamentals that need brushing up, and I think a loan out. I think he's probably good enough to go to one of the lower Premier League clubs, but I think his class would really shine in the Football League Championship, something like that. So I think a loan is doing really well in terms of his technical and physical development. But yeah, hopefully he comes back, and because I think he can be a real important part of the first team set up in a few years' time.
Yeah, I agree. I think he's quality. He's a great little centre back. On any other time in the last like 5 years or so, we get into that Everton team any day. But because we've got such strength there at the moment, because of those two deadline day signings, obviously Zuma and Mina. It's completely changed the picture. Otherwise, Holgate would be having a look in, but he's not having a look at all at the moment. He's played a couple of times for the under-23s, I think, and he needs first-team football, though, because he's at the age where he really was starting to establish himself, and I really like him as a player, and I do think he has a future at Everton, hopefully, but I wouldn't want him to go to like another club and get his head turned kind of thing. Like, if he was going to go to another Prem club, or even, I think he's capable of, I don't know, like a top European club, but somewhere in Europe, like Luchman did, like Leipzig, that kind of thing. Mm. Just get a decent little, maybe even a Europa League team, like a loan out. I wouldn't want him to go out there and get his head turned, but obviously it could develop as him a player, like we've seen with Vlasic when he's gone out and he's developed as a player, but he's got his head turned. Like, I wouldn't want to see that, but I do want to see him develop. But it's sad because obviously we've bought him at a very low price, and we could not sell him on for a very high price, even just to keep him and just keep him at his value, because he's a very good player, and I wouldn't want to see him go. Obviously, I think of him synonymously as that Ashley Williams partnership in the bad old days, where he was obviously they had a bit of a partnership, and I wasn't a massive fan of that, but obviously we got better memories like when he shoved Bobby Firmino into the stands. So he's a good little player, and he's got a nasty side to him, and he's put in some quality tackles when I've watched him play, so I won't be sad to see him go, but I don't know what kind of club he'd be going out to. I don't know, I haven't seen anyone interested in him, but I don't know, is there any rumours about who he's going to?
I don't know, but obviously with the, you know, the mighty Sky Sports sources coming out and officially claiming Marco Silva's, you know, said he can go out on loan, I'm sure there'll be suitors. I think that's a really good point that you raised, that he could go out to a European side. Obviously, a lot of young, you know, promising English players are taking that leap and that taking that opportunity to go and play abroad. We see him particularly in Germany, you know, the likes of Reece Nelson at Hoffenheim, Jadon Sancho at Dortmund, mentioned last season, Luchman at Leipzig. Does he seem like the type that he would take on that challenge? I'd probably say so, because I think his style of play is, you know, it would excel in a league where physicality isn't as prevalent as the Premier League. Obviously, I mean, obviously there's still room for him to develop physically, but he's just got such a grace and a class about him when he's on the ball that would shine in the likes of the Bundesliga or in Serie A, or, you know, any of the top foreign leagues. Again, though, that is whether or not he would take that decision to move abroad. I think if he was to move to an English club, that still wouldn't hinder him as much, and it'd probably do his physical side of his game a hell of a lot more in terms of a move abroad. And that is, I think, what Marco Silva would demand from a centre-half. You look at the centre-half that we have at the moment, Mina, Zuma, Keane, they all are physically very, you know, dominant.
Yeah.
Tall, wide, strong players, and obviously, you know, not to criticise Mason Holgate in any way, but he's still got development to go in that sense, and I think a loan out would fast forward that, and if he was to come back, I think he'd definitely pose a threat to the first team.
Yeah, definitely, he's a player, he's got a future at Everton. I think anyway, because we don't know what the future holds. Maybe we'll manage to keep hold of all the ones we got at the moment. Obviously, Mina's on a permanent. I'm not sure if we manage to get Zuma, because I do think he probably prove his worth here. And then Chelsea might want him back, but they've got choice of centre backs at the moment as well. So never know. We might be able to keep him, but Michael Keane's here for the long term as well. Obviously, Jagielka's probably going to retire soon. I don't know if I see him getting unlucky, because he's a really good player, but we have got options there. He's been played at right back, hasn't he? But in terms of playing at right back as well, has he got a future at right back? Is that an interesting one? Or
I don't think so. I personally, it's not that I don't rate him at centre back. I just don't think he is suited. Right back, sorry. I just don't think he's suited to being a full back. You know, his physical posture, obviously, you know, he's tall. Yeah, not to say he's not athletic, but I don't think speed is one of his key attributes. So I think that's where, you know, he's a tailor-made centre-half. He's got the height, could probably develop the power and the strength. And as we've mentioned earlier, Marco Silva demands that his fullbacks get up and down the line. And, you know, as a young player, I think he'd get caught out of position a few times and get caught in two minds, whether to go forward or whether to defend. And I think his bread and butter is defending, and I think he will develop into an excellent defensive player who has an eye to play out from the back, which is what Marco Silva wants from his centre-halves. So, in a few years' time, I really do think he could be a staple of this Everton side.
Yeah, me too. I think I completely agree about the right-back thing as well. I don't think he was suited to it. He played there under Koeman quite a bit, because I think Koeman preferred him to Kenny, or maybe Kenny was injured back then, but he did play quite a lot at right-back when Coleman was out injured. But he didn't really adapt to it too well. I think he said to the press himself that he'd rather play at centre-back, and obviously he doesn't bomb up and down the line like the modern full-back does. So he's definitely more suited to centre-back, and I can see him hopefully playing there in the future for Everton. But let us know what you think of Mason Holgate anyway, and whether he's got a future at Everton, and whether we send him out on loan. And let us know what you think anyway. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Make sure you like the video, comment and subscribe to the Soffy Blues, and thanks a lot for watching.